Since we're on this track already, Bill, why don't you just explain what, how, you know, you found obviously Joshua's work and others, what it was exactly that gave you this insight that actually the population genetic kind of view was not necessarily the only game in town, and that actually there is a way of reconciling a first human couple with the genetics involved.
There were a series of conferences held at the Carl Henry Center at Trinity Evangelical Divinity School on creation. And part of these were devoted to the question of the historicity of Adam and Eve. And it was at these conferences that I first got to know Josh. And he gave a paper at the conference that previewed his book, The Genealogical Adam and Eve. And it stirred a lot of discussion and provoked a lot of interest.
Yeah, so to give a sense of how this is placing, so my book is one critique of Biologos's argument. And it's really parsing out and saying, you know, actually genealogical ancestry is more important than genetics. And if you do that, Adam and Eve could have been very recent. Now, Bill, his view is that maybe there were people outside the garden, but they wouldn't have had full humanness. Like the way how he sees the theology is that humanness is full, is like really exclusive to Adam and Eve's lineage, where I'm not as convinced of that, but that's neither here nor there. So he came with a different sort of questions about a more ancient time of about maybe 500,000 years ago to 700,000 years ago, about how large did the population of humans, like what is genetics is telling us about that? And the surprising thing is that, although he was being told that population genetics tells us that the population of humans was never less than 10,000, that's just not true. Population genetics just talks about our ancestral population. It doesn't talk about which of those ancestors are human. That's the first thing. But the other issue too is when you get back about, you know, 500,000 years ago, 700,000 years ago, we don't really have good evidence to tell us how large our ancestral population size was.